Hello, and welcome to the first module of our PowerMUX deep dive. My name is Elizabeth Higgins. I'm an applications engineer within the PowerSwitch product line, supporting the PowerMUX portfolio. To begin, let's put the PowerMUX in some context by showing it with the rest of the PowerSwitch portfolio. So, the PowerSwitch product line includes following products. Today, I'll be specifically discussing the PowerMUX. There, it is shown at the input of the system, providing flexible, dual input power distribution. For more information on what the PowerSwitch product line offers aside from the PowerMUX, please visit the link on the upper right-hand corner of this slide. So, what is a PowerMUX? Well, a power multiplexer, or PowerMUX, is a solution which selects between two or more input supplies to deliver power to a single output. These devices are critical for systems which require reliable input power, such as ones with backup battery supplies, or systems which simply require input power flexibility. For instance, a system you'd want to be able to wirelessly charge, but then plug into a wall outlet as well. Now, I have divided up the main configurations and features of PowerMUXes into three key topics we'll be diving deeper into. Of these are automatic versus manual switchover, priority versus ORing configuration, and system protections. We'll begin with the topic of automatic versus manual switchover. Automatic switching uses the power supply itself as a reference to choose which supply is outputted. Here is an example of how this is applied in one of our PowerMUXes, the TPS2121. Here, the switch is controlled by a voltage division from the input supplies. This configuration can be preferable as it does not require an external signal to switch between loads and is great when no microcontroller is available. This simplifies the design architecture and allows the device to remain autonomous in a system. On the other hand, manual switching is where a microcontroller selects between the inputs. Here is an example of our PowerMUX, the TPS2121, being controlled by a microcontroller. This can be helpful if a manual override is needed due to some external condition, or if the user requires the switching condition to be independent of the input voltage level. A priority configuration allows the user to set a supply to be prioritized regardless of its voltage. For instance, if you have a battery that was at a higher voltage than your wired connection, you wouldn't want the battery to drain first. A priority configuration is also needed for systems which have the same input voltage supply, so that a constant evaluation of which supply is greater is not occurring. An ORing configuration instead always chooses the greater supply to deliver power to the load. This is a type of automatic switchover which does not allow for any user override. This configuration should only be chosen when the two input supplies are not the same and the greater input power supply is always preferred to power the load. There are two ways for the two supply lines to disconnect from the load. The lines can be a break before make configuration or a make before break configuration. In a make before break, the second channel is connected to the output before the first channel is disconnected. As you can see in the figure below, this results in an issue of reverse current since both supplies are connected to the output at the same time. Instead, you can use a break before make configuration to ensure no reverse current flows through the device. In this break before make configuration, the first channel is disconnected to the output before the second channel is connected. As shown in the figure, this protects the system from reverse current. However, it does result in an output voltage drop during the time no power is delivered to the load. In the preferred break before make topology, it's important to consider the implications of time where no input is connected to the load. During a switchover event, the voltage will drop. To keep the system operating, the voltage cannot drop below the system's operating range, since this would cause a system reset. For uninterrupted operation, the output voltage needs to remain within the operating range to provide a seamless switchover. Therefore, it's important to consider the switchover time as a key specification in PowerMUX devices. The faster the switchover time, the less output voltage will drop. When selecting a PowerMUX, please consider the following features shown. These will be discussed in further depth in the next deep dive segment. Now that we've covered what a PowerMUX is, What are TI power muxes, and how do we fit into the categories we've discussed? To begin, our TI power muxes provide both automatic and or manual switchover to provide system flexibility to either work autonomously or with system GPIOs. TI power muxes also allow for priority or ORing configurations, which enable the user to establish a user set switchover point and assign priority to a lower voltage supply. TI power muxes are developed in the preferred break before make configurations, with protection options which range from smaller, less complex designs to providing all of the protection features listed in the previous slide. Another key feature of our devices is our integration. While providing all these features, instead of 10 plus discrete components being used, our PowerMux device enables design flexibility with one device in a very small footprint. These devices are also very easy to design with and layout due to the collateral and evaluation modules we make for each device. The evaluation modules shown to the right provide example designs which can be copied and modified as needed and provide a schematic and layout to begin with your design. For more information on PowerMuxes, please visit the link above ti.com/PowerMux. And for more information on the PowerSwitch portfolio, please visit the following links and the following collaterals, specifically our 11 Ways to Protect Your Power Path ebook, which will help you with your next design.